Alright guys, so welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, I just want to share some stuff that I'm having issues with on eBay. So I was going through my transaction history where fees and stuff are being taken out, and I'm getting charged for stuff that I don't even have in my store anymore. And I had to call a representative. And I got to tell you guys, to get in touch with somebody over at eBay is very difficult nowadays. But I'm going to flip my camera around and show you guys what's going on. I might show you a screen recording right now and then explain it to you, because it'll be a lot better quality. So give me 1 second. All right, guys, so I got y'all pulled up on my OBS over here so y'all can see a better clear view of what I'm explaining to you guys. So what the issue was is over here in the payments, I like to look over here in the payments, and remind me later. So right here, this charge, $6.13. So I was looking at this. Bring that up. I was looking at $6.13 charge, and I was scrolling through. This is for insertion fees, guys. I was scrolling through here, and I noticed this bag here, this shirt here. I know for a fact that I've sold these at the flea market. And what I do, after so long, I'll delist some items, take to the flea market. And as you can see, they still charged me October the 30th, 35 cents insertion fee. So now I called a representative over at eBay, and I got to tell you guys, it's super hard to get in contact with someone over there, because they always want to send you like a link for different issues. But I don't know if that's like that for everybody, but every time I've tried to call someone, they want to send you a link to help you do it on the computer. But I just want to talk to someone personally. So this item and this item. But eBay, I did talk to the guy, he's super nice, and he said that just go over my store, which that's going to take a little bit of time and more effort, guys, to do that, to go through my store, and they'll reimburse me the 35 cents. But my store's not that big. I only have like 384 items in. Probably 387 items, because I do have some duplicate items. And, yeah, I know it's only 35 cents, but if you have a large store and then you have like 200-300 items that eBay is still charging insertion fees on that you don't even own anymore, that can become an issue. I mean, I'm just curious, but, let's just say 300 items times 0.35 equals, that's $105, guys. So that can add up, especially if you're not paying attention to, this is what caught my attention, this McDonald's bag and this black button shirt. But yeah, I just wanted to bring that to you guys' attention. Let me know if y'all been having this issue as well. So now what I'm going to have to do is probably I'm going to have to go back over here. And I've done explained how to look in your inventory in previous videos. I'm just going to explain it really quick one more time. So if you go to listings here, and then, which I was already there, I just clicked on it just to start this over. So you just go to here where it says item title, SKU is equal to, I always put contain, and then I'll enter the value of what I'm going to be looking up. So this is filing cabinet drawer 48. So I click on that, and you just do this all the way down through your SKU. And as you can see, 48 drawer has 17 items. So I'll just go outside and see, it's even showing that McDonald's bag and this candy shirt still there, but it's not in my inventory. So evidently eBay didn't delist it. Even though I did delist it, they didn't delist it, or they relisted it. I don't know what happened, but maybe it was a little glitch in the system. I mean, like, they're always updating the eBay site, it seems like, daily. So that's what I'm gonna have to do, guys. I'm just going to have to make sure everything is accounted for, and if not, I need to take it off of here again, because like I said, I like to go through my inventory periodically and take it to the flea market. Like all these items here, I'm probably going to delist these ones, and usually what I do it drawer by drawer when I do take my listings down. So this is in 48 drawer, so I can just like action, edit, action, and then I can just we're in the listings right there. That's how I usually do it. Now I'll just go take everything out of 48, take it to the flea market. That's how I usually do things. But yeah, I just wanted to do this quick video to just update you guys on the issue that I'm having. Comment down below if you're having this issue or had this issue. This is the first time for me that I've actually noticed. It might have happened more than this time. I just haven't noticed it. But the eBay guy told me to find if whatever I found in my store that wasn't there, that they would reimburse me the money. I don't know how that would work, because like I said, it's kind of hard to see when you paid for it and when you didn't pay for it. I mean, if that makes sense, like this right here, if I've sold this, I wouldn't know how long, because they only do like go back 90 days. So 3 months. But yeah, I'm rambling now, guys. Hope this was educational to you guys. Maybe it'll bring some more alertness to everybody that's selling on eBay, just to keep track, because I know I don't keep track like I should, but I need to start focusing a little bit more on this, because this could become a problem. Yeah, I mean, it could be a very big problem if somebody has like 40, 50, 60, 100,000 items in their store. I mean, that could be a real big problem. But yeah, guys, like always, thank you guys for stopping by, watching the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.